tonight will be me. There's also lunch beginning at 1:30. And if you've ever eaten at First Friendship Baptist Church, please show up. It's really good food. But it will be a lovely celebration tonight. And my apologies, because Deanne usually tells me when I make a typo. She missed that one. It is November. It's Gratitude Month. We decorate our homes and our classrooms and the sanctuary with all the sorts of things that remind us of our history and our heritage, our fall and harvest, and of the super humongous meal we're all going to be sharing in a few weeks. I will actually be sharing several of those meals because just about every organization I belong to is having some sort of a Thanksgiving dinner celebration. We complain because the stores are all in Christmas mode already. And we try to think of things that we are grateful for, but sometimes life gets in the way, and it's hard to remember. Now, normally, when this particular scripture comes around, the focus is on that last half sentence. As for me and my household, we will serve the Lord. And usually the preacher talks about what it means to serve the Lord and what false gods or idols might be taking our attention away from God. But this time when I was reading through it, that statement in the middle stuck out as if it had been writ large on a billboard with all kinds of neon lighting around it. Thus says the Lord, I gave you a land on which you had not labored and towns you had not built, and you live in them, and you eat the fruit of vineyards and olive yards that you did not plant. So be grateful, you silly people. Because, I mean, seriously, did they really need to be reminded of what God had done for them? They're just entering the promised land. And yes, frankly, they did have to be reminded. These people did nothing but complain, even with God personally guiding them to their new home, even though God provided manna and quail to feed them every single day, even though God provided sweet, fresh water every time they had to stop so they could feed their livestock and themselves and have plenty of water to drink. Now, when we run into a person like this, we might say something like, he'd complain if you hung him with a new rope. Now, I have no idea why someone would complain about being hung with a new rope. Maybe it's scratchier than an old rope, I don't know. I even looked it up on the internet and nobody seems to know where it comes from. It's just there. But anyway, they had had so much, now you're worried about it. They had had so much stuff just handed to them, but still they complained. They neglected to be grateful. They turned to other gods, the gods of Egypt and Mesopotamia, and even the gods of the people whose land they had just occupied. Here's an old story about two friends who were shoemakers. One was doing pretty well while the other one was less successful. So he asked his old friend for a loan so he could open a shop in a better neighborhood. And his friend, wishing all the best for him, was happy to give him that loan. That new location was a success, and over the years his business flourished until years later he had one of the largest, very most popular shoe manufacturing firms in the whole area. Meanwhile, his old friend, who still had that little shop back in the old neighborhood, was facing financial difficulties. So he went to his successful friend for a very small loan and was turned down. And he said, well, but back in the day, I lent you the money to get a better location, and now you're one of the largest shoe manufacturing firms around. If I hadn't helped today, you would be broke. I know, said his friend, and I appreciate what you did back then, but what have you done for me lately? I think the people of Israel were a little bit like that. I think maybe sometimes we are a little bit like that. I would was so very grateful to qualify for student loans so that I could attend college and seminary. I celebrated every semester when that money came in so I could pay the rent and buy books and tuition, all that other stuff you gotta pay for if you're going to school. Years later, however, I am somewhat less grateful when I make that payment every month. Truthfully, I'm not at all grateful. I can always think of a better way to spend that money. Anything better than paying my student loans, but you know, I have enough. I have enough. Even after I pay the loans, I have enough to live on and feed all four cats and keep the lights on in the parsonage and get a pedicure now and then. I have everything I need. And were it not for those student loans and the education they paid for, I wouldn't be here right now. So I really should be grateful. Everything we have today comes from God. Everything we have received throughout our lives comes from God.
Amen.
Sometimes we forget that. Sometimes we think that the things we have come from our own efforts and that we have no one to thank but ourselves. Yes, we have worked hard to achieve all the things that we have achieved. But without God-given talent, we wouldn't be great musicians and singers and dancers. Without God-given intellect, we wouldn't be teachers and preachers and attorneys. Without God-given compassion and care, we wouldn't be willing to work with people less fortunate than ourselves. Without God's love, we would have no love to share with anyone. Gratitude turns what we have to all we need. Now, as most of you know, Leah and I spend much of the week trying to figure out what picture is going to work best on Sunday morning. And there were a lot of pictures flying back and forth this week until that one. When Leah sent me that one, I said, yep, that's the one. That's it. Because that is so right. Gratitude turns what we have into all we need. You all know, I think, that I have a practice of writing down 10 things I'm grateful for every morning. It should come as no surprise to anyone who knows me at all that coffee is usually at the top of the list. Now, we all know that coffee is a gift from God. Sometimes I write down things, you know, like a car that runs, thank you, Gary, and my Roomba. But most of what's on my list every day can only come from God. Sunrise, rain, cooler weather, cats, friends, people who understand me. I often note on my list that my needs are met. Maybe I don't have everything I want, but certainly I have everything I need and more. And gratitude is more than a good feeling. Acknowledgement of gratitude has to be more than just a list, because gratitude is an action word. It is something we do. When we are grateful, we share that for which we are grateful. We are grateful that we have enough so we buy tomatoes to put in boxes for people who don't have enough. Or we buy toys for children who might not get any on Christmas. Or we might help out at the Christian Cafe or with food distribution at the Smart Center. We're grateful we have furry children, so we help out at a Second Chance Animal Shelter or give money to them. We are grateful for our education, so we make donations to the schools from which we graduated, or we make donations to the Disciples Mission Fund for all of the disciples, schools and universities and seminaries, especially Jackman. It doesn't say that on the paper that you have, but especially Chapman. We are grateful for our police and our firefighters and our city workers, so we say good things about them on Facebook and support them however we can. We are grateful that God gave us voices, so we share our talents in the choir or during congregational singing. We are grateful we have a church home, so we show up and we help out wherever we can, as greeters, as presiders, as people who decorate the sanctuary, thank you, Jeffrey, or baking cookies, or wherever our gifts and talents are needed and useful. And we are grateful that somebody told us about Jesus, so we share the good news with other people. April tells a story that I love, about talking to a college classmate one day about Jesus. She finished a conversation, her roommate was sitting there, and she said, "Why have you never told me that?" Our gratitude for God's gifts, all of God's gifts, should be shared loud and proud so others can know how much God loves us and them and all the people of the world. We share the love of Jesus with each other. We share all of our gifts. And then we have all we need. Amen. If you are called to become family through baptism, you're invited to come forward during the singing of our hymn of commitment, "Now Thank We All Our God."